Welcome to Kipsigis Girls High School, located in Kericho County, just 3 kilometers from Kericho Town. Kericho is well known for tea farming, but amidst the vast tea estate, a gem that molds, shapes, and refines young girls is sandwiched. Kipsigis Girls was established 7 decades ago initially as a Christian girls' boarding school with students' population of 140 pupils. In 1965, it was elevated to a secondary school, and in 1970, an A-level class was started, and this elevated Kipsigis to a high school. Mrs. Christine Chumba has steered the school since October 2021, having taken over from Ms. Juliana Kirui, who went to Moy Girls High School Eldoret, where Ms. Chumba had come from. Currently, the students' population stands at about 1,700. Kipsigis Girls is the only girls' national school in Kericho County.
The school has grown over the years. At the moment, we have a population of 1,695 students, about 68 teachers and 40 members of the non-teaching staff that work as a team. The school has had great support from the parents, through the PA, from the alumni, from the Ministry of Education, through the disbursement of FDSC.
The current BOM chairperson is Mr. Nixon Sigei, who is also the CEO of the new KCC. He has been able to offer wise counsel in the school and improve the governance structure. The infrastructure in the school has continued to expand, with the latest being completion of the 400-capacity dormitory. The ultra-modern administration complex is also on its final stages.
Our infrastructure has mainly been supported by the parents and the Ministry of Education through the MI project. The constituency development fund from my Namoi constituency, we've also gotten support, both bursaries for students and infrastructure development. We have just completed a tuition block that houses the library at the top, 9 classrooms and offices for the teachers. Before that, we had just finished with a dormitory that houses about 400 students.
Kipsigis Girls has been posting sterling KCSE results for the last 3 decades. Last year, the school posted a mean of 9.28 points. This represents 95.1% transition to the university. For the last 5 years, the mean of the school has steadily remained above 9.0, except for 2020, when it dropped to 8.9, following the restrictions arising from the COVID-19 pandemic. The school has produced the best professionals in various fields, ranging from medicine, engineering, law, commerce, art, politics, and many others.
My name is Kezia Odoyo. I studied in Kipsigis Girls from the year 2012 to 2015. I was able to start as an environmental prefect when I was in Form 2, and I was able to also get the position for president, or they call it captain nowadays, in Kipsigis Girls for the year 2014 and 2015. And I am a recent graduate of Maseno University. I studied Bachelor of Medicine and Surgery with IT. And while in Maseno, I was able to do an exchange program with the University of Upstate in Syracuse, New York. And I was able to go to their pediatric department under the Global Health Department.
Some of the notable public figures are Honorable Florence Boller, the Cabinet Secretary for Labor and Social Protection, Honorable Winfrida Mokaya, the Chief Registrar of the Judiciary, Honorable Judith Pareno, former nominated Senator for Kajiado County and East African Legislative Assembly, and Farida Karone, former Cabinet Secretary for Lands. It is a school with liberal philosophy grounded in Christian values. The school does not have a spiritual sponsor since it's managed by the County Education Board, formerly District Education Board, DEB. Here, the Muslim students are allowed to follow the Muslim doctrines.
Assalamu alaikum, my name is Taslim Niazdin. I'm from Mombasa County. I'm in Kipsigis Girls Form 3. I enjoy being here in Kipsigis, and what makes it even more enjoyable is that we are allowed to wear hijabs. We have a worship place that we perform our 5 daily salas, and we are also allowed to celebrate our festive seasons like Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, thank you so much.
Similarly, the Seventh-day Adventist and the Catholics.
My name is Phoebe Kwamboka. I am the Seventh-day Adventist cheerleader in the SD Society in Kipsigis Girls. The SD Society in Kipsigis Girls, we first want to thank the administration. We can indeed say thank you because we are given that freedom to worship each and every Friday, beginning from 4 up to Saturday evening 6.
My name is Brittany Bwire. I'm in 4U. I am the YCS chairlady. The YCS society has a total population of 267 girls. So in our school, we normally have our prayers every 3 times in a week from 6:30 to 6:45. We normally pray the rosary, and by the end of every year we normally have a baptism, which we normally hold it in our school.
A majority of the students, however, fall under the Christian Union, chaired by Michelle Kerubo.
Praise God, everyone. My name is Michelle Kerubo Gisemba. I am the CU chairlady of Kipsigis Girls High School and also the dining hall captain. Today I'd like to share with you the various activities that we have or the programs that we run for the CU body at Kipsigis Girls. We have the departments such as the Bible study, the discipleship, and also the Sunday school for the staff children. And also, in terms of Bible study, we run our Bible studies during the 4 to 5 p.m. period on Sunday. We also have fasting every Friday for the praise and worship. We also do the services. We have an intercession service on Saturday, and we also have on Sunday a service from 8 to 10 a.m. Recently, we've been able to baptize some of our students. This is a program that was started by the school and is being run by the able leaders such as the CU patron, Madam Irene, and the chaplain who has supported the CU in our run. The students who are baptized are about 28, and they're also running forward in their walk with Christ to discipleship this term. Thank you and God bless you.
Spiritual nourishment is the backbone of Kipsigis Girls. The teaching and non-teaching staff spiritual commitment has grown exponentially. Here, we say God lives in Kipsigis. The girls are fashioned to pursue the Lord, and every move and step they make is a step in the right direction.
My major work is to support the girls morally and also to help them to grow in their faith. We have spiritual programs, and it has really helped the school a lot because we know it is good for the modern society to grow spiritually and even socially. And when you talk about students, also they need to grow academically. Now in school, we have spiritual program that helps our girls to grow in their spiritual life. For instance, we have devotions. Every day we have devotion, morning devotion and evening devotion. Morning devotion start at 6 to 6:10, and evening devotion we normally held it at 6:45 to 7. We have the theme of the week, whereby I used to give them the scripture of the week from Monday to Sunday, and the girls impressed with that spiritual program of devotion.
Discipline forms the basis and base for success. The deputy principal, Mrs. Lizzie Kirui, handles administrative and disciplinary issues in the school.
When it comes to students' welfare, the main one is student discipline. So I ensure that when the students are admitted to this school, together with the disciplinary committee, we explain to the form ones our school rules and requirements, so that as they move on, we are able to deal with any discipline issues that arise. We work together with guidance and counseling department and also the chaplaincy department in order to achieve the required standard of discipline for our students. Because some of them, it's not because they've decided to be indisciplined. It could be issues that just require that they are assisted in their level of spirituality, or they are cancelled because of the things they could be going through. And once usually those ones are sorted, those students are able to settle and they remain focused with no discipline issues. This school, because of the population and the big number of dormitories and classes, we have a prefect's body of 80 girls. We have a head girl, two deputies, and then prefects in various departments. So my work is also to ensure that I oversee the selection process of prefects, their induction, and then now as they do their work, like we have weekly meetings, and we even have a disciplinary committee among the prefects. So the prefects help us a lot in ensuring that there is proper management of student body. It's also an opportunity to groom these young leaders as they carry out their duties. So that's my work, that the prefects are guided to do their work well and that they take advantage of it to grow as leaders. We usually do prefect selection in July, and a term is 1 year. And how we go about it is there's a mixture of democracy and also the teacher involvement. So some weeks before the day of election, we release requirements so that every student is aware that if I want to be a head girl, I must have this grade. I need not to have done 1, 2, 3. So it is put on the notice board, and then students apply if they meet those requirements and when they're interested in whichever position. There is a timeline in that list that we release. On the day that it elapses, there's a committee of teachers that vets through those applications and a shortlist is produced. Then these girls who have been shortlisted will face a panel of teachers, and usually start with the lowest level and we finish with the head girl. So those who have been shortlisted will face the panel of teachers who will interview them, and then depending on how they've presented themselves, we place those girls into the respective positions.
My name is Beckley Arisa. I'm in Form 3S and I'm the deputy captain in charge of administration in Kipsigis Girls High School. So my work as a deputy captain in charge of administration is to ensure that the students are well in their dormitories and they maintain proper hygiene and sanitation in their houses and also in their classes.
My name is Sandra Sopiato. I am the deputy school captain in charge of academics. I'm a Form 4. I'm in 4Z, and the reason why I love Kipsigis Girls is because of the facilities that we have. The students get a nice opportunity to read. There's a conducive environment. The teachers are always friendly, and also the students are always very cooperative. And my work as the deputy captain in charge of academics is to ensure all the reports on the attendance of the teachers are brought to the deputy principal, and also to ensure that all the learners are well equipped with all the stationery books that they need to learn.
It is not only the academic excellence that has catapulted Kipsigis Girls to the top, but also the extracurricular activities. The girls have scooped major awards in music, sports and drama festivals.
Students are actively involved in extracurricular activities, and I want to say that our best is of course music, and I want to sincerely thank the music teacher, Mr. Massini, particularly for his passion in what he does.
There are various vibrant clubs in the school that expose the students and expand their worldview. The first one is the St. John's Ambulance Club that enables them to do outreach activities to the community. The second one is a Scout and Girl Guide.
Other co-curricular activities that we participate in is Scouts, St. John's, ball games, athletics, drama, science fair, and the basketball team has just come from the regional games in Kapsabet, and they were the third after Nasakol and St. Joseph's girls, Kitale. We want to encourage that the students participate actively in co-curricular activities so that they are able to use their energies and therefore be able to settle well when they are in class.
Drama and music clubs have propelled Kipsigis Girls to the national arena.
My name is Purity Langat. I am the patron drama club at Kipsigis Girls. Drama is the most vibrant and engaging club in Kipsigis. It attracts expressive, passionate and creative students. These students have made us earn many awards, and we are proud of that. We usually participate in plays, the choral verse, the solo verse, spoken word, modern and solo dances. That is where the girls really choose to participate.
So one of the major duties I have in this school is to nurture the talent of these young ones in vocal music and even instrumental music. So we are having a very robust music class and music club. We are doing very well. We've gone up to national level for the 3 years, that is 2022-2023, and even this year we are intending to go up to the highest level of the competitions. And this subject has grown at a very high speed, because being a young subject in the school, we've registered our first main score this year, 2023, and we came up with 9.7. So the subject has really grown. It started in 2021, and by now we are now well established. In terms of co-curricular, the girls are doing very well. The girls are singing very well. The girls are playing the music instruments. We have a young band. The current players of the band are from 3 students, and they have learned at a very high speed, and they're doing very well. From 4s also do the band, but now they are the senior most members, so we don't engage them in most of the times. We are now engaging from 3s, and we are planning for a wonderful performance this year in both co-curricular and even in our music subject. So we are hoping for the best, and we want to thank the management through the BOM chair and our principal, Madam Chumba, for the great support financially and even morally. There are times she joins us at the festival, she gives us moral support, she has supported the subject, she has bought us the instruments, the books, we have them in plenty, and the subject is just moving. So we are saying we are on our way to being Kenya One.
Being a tea growing zone, students are also molded to be future farmers. They learn this at the school tea farm of 7 acres. The revenue from the farm eases the pressure from the parents by financing some of the school projects.
My name is Neema from Kipsigis Girls High School, and here we are at the tea plantation. This is a project that the school started in the year 2002, and it has had many advantages to the school. First and foremost, it has created employment to the community around the school. Secondly, it has helped the school to earn some income as it is sold to the industries as the raw materials. And also it has helped the students in terms of applying the concept that they get in class. For example, we learn about pruning, and we've gotten to see it practically and how it helps by isolating spraying and also maintaining the plucking tape.
The school also has a modern dairy farming unit that produces sufficient milk for daily consumption.
My name is Sydney Chakiri, an agriculture student from 4, 2024. Through the concepts we learn in class, I like the management practices carried out on the cattle, like dehorning, castration, identification. We've always had the opportunity to come here and witness, and it has really helped us. Since whenever we see, we have that memory built in us, like, yeah, we surely remember. Mm-hmm. Like, we also see even the principles, let's say, of controlling parasites, like, usually, yeah, the proper feeding, yes, the proper breeding and research and such, yes. We always come here and witness them, and yeah, it has been really good.
The school raised about 30 to 40 cows, and these cows are the freshens. They have very high milk yield. Yes, they produce a lot of milk in a day. For example, the school receives almost about 160 liters in a day, whereby we use it in the kitchen area and others are sold to the excess are sold to the market.
Agriculture has a good number of students, and here they are preparing their 2024 KCSE project.
Agriculture is an art as well as a science, so most of the time we'll do the teaching in class, and we also do the practicals, because being an art you have to go out and we do the art, and then we put into practice the principles of crop and animal production. This year's KCSE project, we also have a KCSE project that these girls need to go to the field. They can do either crop production or animal production. So for this year we had a variety of crops to choose from, but before we decided on what to do, the girls were supposed to go out and evaluate the problem. So this year's project and even last year's project, it was not all about the school or the administration choosing the project. It borrows much on what we are doing in the CBC curriculum, whereby it involves collaboration, it involves teamwork and innovation. So for the girls, this year's KCSE project, the girls were to identify what is the problem that we are having within our community, identify the project, come up with the ways of how the agriculture project can solve the problem. So the girls did some presentations, different groups did some presentations, and then we worked together again with the administration, and then we identified maize as one of the projects that we are going to carry out.
Okay, my name is Hilary Kemto Oseno. I am in 4Z and I am an agriculture student. So today we are here to prepare ourselves for the KCC project, that is cultivation of maize.
Mr. Charles Kirui has been the Parents Association chair since 2014. He acts as a link between the parents and the teachers by coordinating resource mobilization for infrastructure.
The work of a PA chair is, one, is to represent the parents in BOM or Board of Management meetings. The role of a PA also is to mobilize the parents and ensure that the school has enough infrastructural facilities like classrooms, dormitories, dining hall, and the rest of that. And also to coordinate and become a link between the parents and the teachers, so that the academic programs in the school are done well. In this case, therefore, it involves mobilizing the parents to raise finances for academic programs in the school and also for infrastructural facilities in the school.
Everything in this school is executed meticulously and with utmost precision. From the gate to the kitchen, from the classrooms to the library, and from the field to the laboratory, the system is fully functional. The laboratory is well equipped and learners are able to follow and demonstrate chemical and other experiments easily. Kipsigis Girls brings the best from an ordinary student. The students' ambitions here are humongous due to the kind of exposure and guidance offered by the best teachers drawn from the various parts of the country.
We have
able teachers who work with us, teach us to ensure that we come out as the best students. They bring out the best in us. Kipsigis Girls is an all-round school, and being here will help you develop in all dimensions, not only in the academic sector, the out of the curriculum sector, and lastly, you will also develop moral values. We have a slogan in Kipsigis Girls that Kipe ni kwa kina Mungu, this is where God dwells, and we have our verse, Psalms 27, some trust in horses, some trust in chariots, but we as Kipsigis Girls trust in the name of the Lord. So Kipsigis Girls is a God-fearing school, one that serves the Lord, one that believes in God, and we barely have indiscipline cases because of this moral that is always guiding us.
The students and teachers set smart targets every time. This enables them to keep on improving their grades. The students here carry the face of Kenya. This shows that the school has implemented the spirit of nationalism to the letter.
My name is Adut Manyok, the current Miss Kipsigis Girls 2023. I actually won the talent show that is being the model of the school, and I got to be the best among the models, and I took the Miss Kipsigis title. And I'm actually from Southern Sudan, but I lived in Kenya. I've started my schooling here in Kenya, so I've learned how to speak Kiswahili and English, so I'm part of Kenya, yeah. But my origin is from South Sudan.
The art and design lesson teaches students how to design their dreams. Art activates the dormant part of the brain. Mr. Rendon Chikondi explains why art and design is a crucial subject at Kipsigis Girls High School.
My name is Rendon Chikondi, a teacher of art and design here at Kipsigis Girls High School. Our main objective is to nurture talent. We have art classes from Form 1 to Form 4. We also have the art club to cater for the art lovers in school. Our activities for the art club include drawing, painting, beadwork, weaving, sculpting, collage, montage, and also creative writing. We take part in competitions, and I'm glad to report that we've been given several awards in several competitions, including the Giraffe Center AFU Awards, the Ikitabu, and the First Ladies Mama Rachel Mazingira Award of 2023. We at Kipsigis Girls welcome you to be part of us as we continue to nurture talent.
Computer usage here is an ordinary and basic thing that every learner must master. In some instances, the teacher gives students CDs or USBs to download notes and transfer to their books, or vice versa. This enhances and increases their computer interaction and improves learning experiences. Water is life, goes the saying. Water points are strategically placed in accessible sections within the school. This reduces time wastage and enhances efficiency. The school menu is not ordinary high school menu. Here the students eat enough, not less, not much, but just balanced.
My name is Justine Jepchumba Tarus, and in the Kipsigis fraternity, in the morning we take a breakfast at 6:10 a.m. and in the morning we take 3 slices of bread together with tea. At tea break, which is always at 10 a.m., we have this delicious bun and also a cup of tea made by our own bakery. On the sector of lunch, on Monday, on Wednesday, and on Friday, we usually have a sakotage mixed with potatoes. And also on Saturday and on Sunday, we have rice together with beans.
On the days of sakotash, when we take sakotash for lunch, we usually take ugali in the evening and skuma. And on Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday, we usually take cabbage, ugali and spiced garnished beef.
As soon as a parent or guardian steps into Kipsigis Girls during admission day, they realize that the system works and the admission process is seamless.
Today was a very special day to us because we are receiving form ones. There are about 450 form ones that we are expecting today. We opened the gates at 5 a.m. and we found parents at the gate, and we started the process around 7. And we trust that by around 1, we shall have concluded the process of admission for today.
The weather in the school is a mixture of cold and hot, with an average temperature of 24 degrees Celsius. It is only in July when it drops to about 15 degrees Celsius.
Welcome to Kipsigis Girls. My name is Kericho County. I've been your narrator, Karibu Kipsigis.